Episode number 42. This cry was generally heeded, for the Mosquitoes were known to be enemies of the Cardinal, and were beloved on account of the hatred they brought his eminence. Thus the soldiers of other companies than those which belonged to the Red Duke, as Aramis had called him, often took part with the King's Mosquitoes in these quarrels. Of three guardsmen of the company of M.D.S.A. two were passing, two came to the assistance of the four companions, while the other ran towards the hotel of M. de Tréville, crying, "To the rescue, Mosquitoes! To the rescue!" As usual, this hotel was full of soldiers of this company, who hastened to the succor of their comrades. The melee became general, but strength was on the side of the Mosquitoes. The Cardinal's guards, and M. de la Trémouille's people retreated into the hotel, the doors of which they closed just in time to prevent their enemies from entering with them. As to the wounded man, he had been taken in at once, and, as we have said, in a very bad state. Excitement was at its height among the Mosquitoes, and their allies, and they even began to deliberate whether they should not set fire to the hotel to punish the insolence of M. de la Trémouille's domestics in daring to make a sortie upon the King's Mosquitoes. The proposition had been made, and received with enthusiasm, when fortunately 11 o'clock struck. D'Artagnan and his companions remembered their audience, and as they would very much have regretted that such an opportunity should be lost, they succeeded in calming their friends, who contented themselves with hurling some paving stones against the gates. But the gates were too strong. They soon tired of the sport. Besides, those who must be considered the leaders of the enterprise had quit the group, and were making their way towards the hotel of M. de Tréville, who was waiting for them, already informed of this fresh disturbance. "Quick to the Louvre," said he. "To the Louvre without losing an instant, and let us endeavor to see the king before he is prejudiced by the cardinal. We will describe the thing to him as a consequence of the affair of yesterday, and the two will pass off together." M. de Tréville, accompanied by the four young fellows, directed his course towards the Louvre, but to the great astonishment of the captain of the Mosquitoes, he was informed that the king had gone stag hunting in the forest of Saint-Germain. M. de Tréville required this intelligence to be repeated to him twice, and each time his companions saw his brow become darker. "Had his majesty," asked he, "any intention of holding this hunting party yesterday?" "No, your excellency," replied the valet de chambre. "The master of the hounds came this morning to inform him that he had marked down a stag. At first the king answered that he would not go, but he could not resist his love of sport, and set out after dinner." "And the king has seen the cardinal?" asked M. de Tréville. "In all probability he has," replied the valet, "for I saw the horses harnessed to his eminence's carriage this morning, and when I asked where he was going, they told me, to Saint-Germain." "Is beforehand with us," said M. de Tréville. "Gentlemen, I will see the king this evening, but as to you, I do not advise you to risk doing so."